Hello students. So students, in the previous class, in the chapter that is separation of substances, we were talking about the pure substances, we are talking about the impure substances and the component of the substance. So what is a pure substance? Pure substance is a substance in which it consisting of only one type of a substance, only one type of a particles, that is known as a pure substance. Okay, like you see, if suppose we will say that this is a rice, okay, so if it consisting of only the rice in it or the rice particles in it, then we will say that it is a pure one. If we will say this is a milk, so if it is not consisting of a much more amount of a water or any other kind of a things, any other kind of a fluid in it, then yes, that is a pure milk. So when we decide the purity, it totally depends that whether it consisting of a other kind of a components in it or not. If it does not consisting of any other kind of a component, that kind of a substance is known as a pure substance. Okay, so we had already discussed about it, that is what is a pure substance and what is a impure substance. You see, pure substances and impure. Pure substance and impure substance. Okay. Now, when we talk about the impure substance, students, what does that mean? Which consisting of a more than a one type of a component, that is known as a impure substance. Okay. So, consisting of a two or more component in it. Like you see, student, if suppose we will say that it consisting of a rice and the small pebbles or a stone is there. So that is what? That is an impure. Whenever we use the term impure, this is not pure, this is an impure. It means it consisting of any other thing. That other thing will be the harmful one. That other thing can be the undesirable component. That is one thing. Okay, but whenever we say that this is an impure substance, it means it consisting of more than a one type of a component in it. That is an impure substance. Okay, now what is the meaning of a component or the constituent of a substance? Component or the constituent of the substance. It means the things which is present in that substances, that is known as a component of a substance. It means when we talk about a pure or impure, the substance, what are the things by which that particular substance is made up of, that is known as a constituent or the component of the substance. Okay. Now let us see that one more thing is there, student. When we talk about the impure substances, impure substance is also, we use a term for it that is known as a mixture. Okay, so we can say it is also known as mixture. Now, the separation of the, if we talk about the impure substance, there must be some separation technique that we should apply to separate the two or more component which is present in the mixture, okay, or which is present in a substance, making it an impure substance, okay. And why, what is the purpose of the separation of the different substances from the mixture, student? So let us write it again and try to understand it. You see, What are the different purpose? You can say that the various purpose for separating component of the mixture. Okay, what are the various purpose for the separating of the component of the mixture? So the first one is to separate, to remove or to separate the undesirable components. Okay, so we can write it to remove undesirable components. Okay, to remove the undesirable component. Now you see, what is the different example by which we can understand to remove the undesirable component? You see students, very best example to understand this concept is the tea. How? You see, to prepare tea, what are the things that we need? We need tea leaves. We need sugar. We need water. We need milk. Okay? Tea leaves, sugar, water, milk. So these are the different substances, students. These are the different components which when we mix together, then there will be formation of another kind of a substance that is known as a tea. Okay. Now, you see that when we prepare tea, after the formation or after the preparation, the thing which is left behind, that is not a desirable one. Okay. So, what we used to do, we used to filter it. Okay. And throw it. So that is what, that is the removal of the undesirable substances. We don't want it. It is not a harmful, student. You are knowing that because we prepare all the thing with the help of that, with the help of the tea leaves. Okay. So basically the sugar, water and the milk get mixed with each other and the tea leaves, it remain after, even though it also helping giving the flavor, helping giving the color, but after that it will remain behind as a waste product, right? So we can say that tea leaves will be left behind. It is not in use now. So we will remove it by filtering it. Now this is what, this is the undesirable component. We don't want it because we want to drink the tea only, the filter part only, right? So we will say that we remove the undesirable component. Okay, so we can say after the formation we used to throw. We used to throw the tea leaves left behind. We used to throw the tea leaves which is left behind. So this is what, it is an undesirable component. We don't want it, we don't want to take it. So that will comes in an undesirable component. Remember that it is not a harmful one, but it is an undesirable component. Now the second one is to remove harmful component. next one is to remove the harmful component. Now here the mixture consisting of a useful component, mixture consisting of a harmful gas, a harmful component. Okay, so we have to remove it, and this removal, it help in making the substances a pure and the harmful one. It means we use that technique by which we can separate the two components. One is the harmful component, another one is the useful component. For example, students, food grains like pulses, wheat, rice, maize. Okay, so you see the food grains or cereals, they basically like that of a wheat is there, rice is there, pulses is there. You see students, this also consisting of a small pebbles or small stone, as well as insects are also there, right? So what we used to do, we used to separate it, right? We used to separate it, and the stones, the small stones and that of the insect is what? It is the harmful component that should be removed from the different food grains. Okay, so we should remove it so that the useful component can be easily separated from that of the harmful component. Okay, so we can say that these consisting of the small stones, insects, which is harmful for harmful to us. Okay, so we can say that I'm writing it here itself. So we should separate these components from the useful one. Okay, so we should separate these components from the useful one. So to remove harmful component from the useful component, so these all are the harmful components, so we should remove it from, we should separate it from that of the useful component, students. So this is the second one, to remove the harmful component. Next one is to obtain pure sample of a substance. Okay, so we can say next one, to obtain the pure sample of substance. Pure sample of the substances. You see, students, that there are the substances which consisting of the other substances, and we have to purify it. Okay, so the separating technique or the separating methods also help in obtaining the pure form of the substance. Like we can say the petroleum product. Okay. Or you see, or we can obtain the pure form of water. So you see, student, you have heard about the tap water and distilled water. Tap water and distilled water. Tap water is what, students? A water which used to come to our home. Now this water also consisting of a salt in it, right? It consisting of a salt in it, or salt is dissolved in this water. Sorry. But in case of a distilled water, now you see, students, since it consisting of a salt in it, we cannot use it for preparing medicines. Even it is not used for any kind of a chemical process to be carried out. You see, students, this tap water is not used in a laboratory also, okay, for carrying the experiment, because it consisting of a iron, is consisting of the salts. So we can say that since it consisting of a salt, it is not fit for the experiment. It is not fit for making the medicines. Okay, so instead of using the tap water, we use the distilled water. Now the water is the same here, but we used to purify the water so that tap water get converted into distilled water, and then we can say that this distilled water does not consisting of any salt in it. So tap water consisting of a salt in it, distilled water does not consisting of a salt in it. Okay, let me write it all the thing point by point. Tap water. Consisting of salt in it. Okay. Tap water consisting of a salt in it. So it cannot be used for preparing medicine. So since it consisting of a salts in it, students, so it cannot be prepared for medicines. So we have to purify. Again, students, we are obtaining the pure sample of a substance. So we are taking the tap water which consisting of a salt in it, and finally we will purify it so that we get the pure substance of water. Okay, so we can say, so we have to purify it to get the pure form of water called distilled water. Does not consisting of salt in it. Okay, so now this water is used for a for making the medicines. So you can say, students, that we can obtain the pure form of a, or pure sample of a substance Example, that if an impure water is there, it cannot be used for a purpose. So we have to purify it. That purified water is known as a distilled water. This distilled water does not consist of a salt in it. So we can use it for the making the medicines. Okay. Next one is to obtain useful component. Okay. To obtain useful component. Now you see, how to obtain the useful component? You see, student, I already had said about the petroleum. So you see, petroleum oil, it is a mixture. When we talk about the petroleum oil, student, so that petroleum, the word petroleum, you will understand that yes, we are talking about the petrol. But no, petroleum oil, it is a mixture. And that is why we cannot use it as a fuel, okay, in the form of a petrol or diesel. So what we have to do, we have to obtain, we have to extract the petroleum product, the petrol, so that means that is what, that is the useful component which we can use as a fuel. Okay, so you see, so petroleum mixture is there, petroleum oil is there, students. So petroleum oil, basically it is a mixture of a petrol, it is a mixture of a diesel in it. So what we have to do, we have to purify, okay, we have to purify it so that we can get the fuel, because we cannot take the petroleum oil as such, okay. So we have to purify, we have to separate the different components which is present in the petroleum oil, that is petrol, that is diesel, and later on we will use it as a fuel. Okay, so we can write it, petroleum oil is a mixture. Which cannot be used as a it cannot be used as a fuel in homes and vehicles. So what we have to do, we have to separate this petroleum mixture so that we can get the petrol and the diesel separately, and then we can use it as a fuel. Okay. Separate the petroleum mixture so that we get diesel petrol etc. in the form of fuel. Okay, so we have to separate this petroleum mixture, students. And finally, we can use it in the form of a fuel that petrol and that of the diesel. So these are the purpose of separating the component into the different mixture. Okay, so the first one is to separate the undesirable component. If two components are given and we don't want the other one, then we use the separating technique for it, separating method for it, to separate the different components of the mixture. The second one is student to remove the harmful components from it. If the component or the substance consisting of the harmful component which can harm to us, which can harm to the person who consume it, ultimately we have to remove it. We have to separate it. So for that purpose also we use the separating method. Then the third one is to get the pure form of a substance. Okay, if you want a pure form like the distilled water I told you, so if you want the pure form to so we have to purify it. We have to take the separating technique which help in purifying it. So we purify and then we can use it. Finally, to obtain the useful component. Okay, so we get the useful component. To get the useful component, that is a purpose of separating the component of a different mixture. Now, what are the different methods? So we have discussed the purpose of separating component of the mixture. Now, what are the different methods that we can use so that we can get the pure form of a component, the useful form of a component from the substance. Okay, so you see the method of separation of the mixture. Method of separating mixture. Method of separating mixture, students. Now see students, different components are having different kind of physical properties. Like some of them are hard, some of them are soft, some of them are soluble, other one is not soluble, someone is bigger in size, another one is not bigger in size, someone is having higher density, other one is having lower density, one is having high boiling point, other is having low boiling point, one is attracted towards magnet, other are not attracted towards magnet. So these are what? These are the physical properties of the substances, of a different substance, right? And on that basis, we can decide the different separating technique. So we can say that it is the physical property of the component which decide the different separating techniques. Different separating techniques or methods. So we can write it, the various component having different physical properties. The various component having different physical properties like hardness, density is there, solubility is there, then size of the particle, students. Some of them are bigger in size, some of them are not bigger in size. Size of particles. Then attraction towards magnet. Okay, all these things are what? These are the different physical properties which the different substances they possess. Okay, And since the different substances, they are having the different physical properties, so we can say that on this basis, the different separating method we can apply. Okay.